In this clip, we will be learning how to use this version of the application to easily automate the modeling process. This type of modeling can be helpful for beginners, modeling simple parts, and saving time in time-intensive jobs. We will be going through six different steps. The first is using the improved region segmentation command. The second is inserting revolution features. The third is cutting the revolution features. The fourth is inserting an extrusion feature. The fifth is inserting a sketch. And the sixth and final step is inserting a fillet. In this version of the application, the region segmentation command has been improved to more accurately segment regions. The application automatically recognizes features by regions on a mesh, allowing a user to insert, cut, or fillet it. Before semi-automated modeling can occur, a model needs to be segmented into regions. First, click the Region Group Mode button, which will automatically start the Auto Segment command. When the regions are created, you can see many regions separated by shape, and each shape will be assigned a random color. Now, we will insert a revolution feature. Right-click the cone feature to display the pop-up menu and go to the Insert Merge command. XOR will intelligently decide whether to use the extrusion command or the revolution command. In this example, the application understands a revolution needs to be made and automatically enters the revolution wizard. The application will intelligently select similar shapes to the cone. If a region is selected that is not desired, simply deselect it by clicking on it directly. And if a desired region is not selected, just click on it to add it. The Revolution Wizard will take all of the selected regions and internally generate polylines, sketches, and axes, and use them to create a solid body. When the mesh is hidden, the solid body can be seen. Now, we will insert another revolution in the disc-shaped part of the model. Once again, we will right-click on an ideal region for the application to find other similar connected regions, and the pop-up menu will be displayed. Click on the Insert Merge command again, and select any regions that were not automatically selected. Since it is a revolution, both sides of the revolution do not need to be selected in order to create it. Now the revolution is finished, and a hole needs to be cut in the middle of the disc shape. Select the center region, right-click, and go to the Cut command. Make sure the correct regions are automatically selected, and then finish the command. The protrusion shape on the cylinder needs to be created. Using the same methods as we have so far, extrude the region. New for this version is the inclusion of the current extrusion and candidate extrusion direction arrows. The red arrow indicates the current extrusion direction, and it can be changed by clicking one of the gray candidate extrusion direction arrows. Based on the regions, the application automatically fillets one corner, so move the resolution slider to min to keep the intended shape. Now we will look at the second protrusion shape on the disc. Right-click on a region and go to Insert Sketch in the pop-up menu. This command is available in the pop-up menu because not all entities are going to be revolutions or extrusions, and with the Insert Sketch option, a sketch can be quickly created on a model. Once section polylines are generated, a sketch can easily be created. Normally, one section polyline is used, but for this command, multiple lines are created to achieve more accurate results. Close off the sketch with another line and two corner trims. Execute the extrude command and change the direction of the extrusion. Run the fillet command on the resulting extrusion. Note that the application can estimate the radius automatically to make the process easier. Fillet the extrusion on the cylinder using the same method as the extrusion on the disc. This version contains new cutting-edge algorithms that enable the automation of cuts and fillets, allowing the application to estimate all appropriate values and choosing the best possible method. The model, from start to finish, using quick modeling, is now complete.